Recently, I bought a few more solar panels for my new garage. So I went online to look for an MPPT charger to connect them to the solar panels and charge my 48-volt, 100-amp-hour battery bank. After some consideration, I decided not to buy one, but instead try to build a 58 MPPT charger myself using the components I already have. I will share my design if you're interested. You can download it and build it yourself. Big thanks to JLCPCB for generously sponsoring this project. Honestly, a lot of my projects probably wouldn't have worked out without their support. Right now, JLCPCB is running some great deals on 6-layer PCBs, with plenty of discount codes worth up to hundreds of dollars. Their PCB and PCBA quality is top-notch, thanks to their advanced manufacturing tech. Make sure to sign up using the link below the video to grab these deals today. First, let's take a look at the main structure of this MPPT charger. Basically, it's a buck converter. The output voltage and current can be adjusted by changing the duty cycle of the MOSFET drive signal. When the duty cycle changes, the output voltage changes accordingly. The microcontroller calculates the maximum power it can extract from the solar panels and precisely controls the MOSFET pulse width. The key point here is that we're using an N-channel MOSFET in this circuit. That means we can't drive the high side MOSFET in the usual way. We need an additional 15 volts auxiliary supply to power the MOSFET gate driver separately. I designed a control PCB based on the block diagram we looked at earlier. The control system includes a power board with two outputs, 12 volts and 15 volts. The 12 volt rail powers the cooling fan and is also stepped down to 3.3 volts and 5 volts to supply the MCU and other ICs. The 15-volt rail is used to power the MOSFET gate driver. This is the complete schematic and PCB for the project. You can download everything from the link in the description below this video. Next, log into JLCPCB and upload the Gerber file I provided. JLCPCB offers an intuitive 3D viewer, so you can preview what your PCB will look like before it's actually manufactured. You can also choose the PCB color, board thickness, and many other options. The PCB cost is very affordable, sometimes even cheaper than a cup of coffee. And don't forget to apply the discount codes to your order. They can save you a significant amount of money. After just 1 week, I received my PCBs. They look great. Everything is accurate and perfectly matches the design. If you're in a hurry, you can choose DHL Express shipping. It's very fast, but the cost is significantly higher. Next comes the component soldering process. It's honestly very boring and tiring. Hand soldering SMD components is much harder than working with through-hole parts. I genuinely recommend using a PCBA service instead of doing it by hand. The components in this circuit are very common, and with JLCPCB's huge parts library, they'll definitely do a great job. I've finished soldering the basic components on the control board. The next step is to power it up and check whether all the supply voltages are correct. This is very important. If you solder the MCU without carefully checking the power rails first, the MCU can be destroyed if the voltage goes above its rated limit. There are four voltages that need to be checked: 12 volt, 5 volts, 3.3 volts, and 15 volts. Right now, all of them look good. This project was inspired by Tech Builder's MPPT project. He's an amazing guy, and you should definitely check out his original project on Instructables to learn more about MPPT design. I also used an ESP32 for this project. I bought a few dozen of them earlier and still hadn't used them. You can solder the ESP32 onto the board using a hot air station or a reflow hot plate. In my case, I'm using a small mini hot plate. This is the PCB after all the soldering is done. We need to remove the leftover flux from the board. The easiest way to do that is by using acetone or alcohol. And this is the final result. It actually looks pretty good for a hand-soldered PCB, right? Next, we'll flash the firmware and give it a test. I'll apply an input voltage of around 25 volts to this module first, then carefully check all the power supply voltages one more time. If everything looks good, we'll turn on the power for the MCU. The display will only show a welcome message because the MCU isn't connected to the main board yet. It can't communicate with the sensors and can't fully start up. See you in the next video, where I'll build the power board and test this MPPT circuit.